G'day mates, welcome to this video. I'm out here in Jackson, Wyoming right now and it's absolutely beautiful. I wanted to get a nice shot of the mountains here behind us. We're actually just about to head home at the moment and this last 7 to 10 days has been such an incredible experience being out here. But today I wanted to talk a little bit about how to make 2019 your best year ever. And the reason why I want to do that is because I've, you know, like I've said in my last video, I've been out here reflecting, really thinking about the things that have been going on in my life and reflecting on 2018 and kind of planning for 2019 and kind of what the future has in store for my businesses and for my life next year. And I really wanted to help you guys to I'll give you some pointers on how you can make this year one of your best years yet, okay? So that's what we're going to be diving into this video, so let's get right into it. So what I'm going to be doing in this video is going over 4 main tips or pieces of advice that I can give you going into 2019 to really make it the best year that you've ever had. And these pieces of advice are based on my own experience and just things that I've learned that can really, that have really helped me to hit my goals and are going to help me going into 2019 that I really just wanted to share with you. The first thing I wanted to do though is just kind of tell you a little bit of a story or give you a bit of an analogy before I jump into my first point here. I'm just going to make sure that I can hit on all my points. So I have my phone here with those on there. But the first thing I wanted to share is I wanted to paint a picture for you. And I want you to think about how, you know, whenever we want to travel somewhere to a destination, whether it's, you know, locally or we're traveling across states or countries or whatever the case may be, we always know the destination, right? Like we know where we're going. And a lot of times we can just pull up our GPS and simply put in our destination and we'll, you know, it'll take us to that place. Now, the important thing to note here is that goals and planning and being able to accomplish the things that you want in life, to have success in your life, you have to have a destination, but more importantly, you need to have a plan or a roadmap in order to know which turns to take and where to go and what direction you need to take. So much like you use a GPS to know which streets to turn left or right to go straight, and to get you to your destination, there could be dozens and dozens of turns that will help you get to your destination, but you know that by going and following that route, that it will get you to your final destination. Now, if you didn't have that, then what would happen? You'd probably end up driving around nowhere, not really knowing where you're going or what to do, right? And you just end up never getting to your destination. So we have this GPS, we know exactly what turns to take, and we can relate this to planning and goals, right? We have certain plans that we make, and we lay out our roadmap for our lives or that year, and we go ahead and work towards that to reach our end destination, which is our end goals, right? So I want you really want you to keep that analogy in your mind when you're thinking about goal setting and planning this year to really, you know, make 2019 well. If you haven't been setting out your roadmap for your life or your year in 2018, if you haven't been setting goals and you haven't been able to track those goals or you know, do daily things that help you, you know, take those left and right turns towards your destination, then this video is going to be really helpful for you to understand the important aspects that will play into helping you be successful next year, okay? So the first point that I wanted to talk about here is map out your year, all right? So when it comes to mapping out your year, really what you want to be doing is you want to be sitting down and thinking about all the things that you've done this year, both good and things that could have gone better, and writing them down and trying to plan out even just little milestones or little goals that you want to work towards going into 2018, okay? So when I do my planning and when I'm sitting down, you know, these last few weeks and even these next few days going into the 2019, what I'm trying to do is identify what is my greater vision, what is my mission, what am I trying to accomplish in the next 20, 30, 40 years? How am I trying to make an impact on people, on the world, right? Now, obviously I know you can't always know exactly what that is right from the get-go, but you can kind of get, you know, you kind of have something you wanna work towards. If you haven't figured it out yet, I highly encourage you guys to really sit down and think about, how do I wanna change the world? How do I wanna make an impact? How do I wanna help people? Okay, so getting back to my point, planning. what you want to be doing is making sure that the things that you're planning for next year that you want to accomplish, whether it's start a new online business, or reach a certain income goal for your business, or you want to quit your 9-to-5 job, or you want to get fit and healthy, and you want to be able to run a marathon, or maybe you want to get really good at a certain sport, or you really want to improve your relationships with your spouse, or your family, or your friends, whatever the case may be, plan it out, write it down, what things you want to do and accomplish next year, okay? And so this planning phase is super important for us to understand what goals to actually set for next year. So planning is kind of very much involved with kind of brainstorming and writing things down, just getting everything out on paper. And I like to use Evernote for mine. I love Evernote because I can keep track of everything there. Sometimes you also use Google Docs as well. But you can even just use, you can write down a piece of paper, all your goals and all that, map it out. And so when you're planning, make sure you're just putting everything that you want to do and achieve without thinking of, limitations or anything like that. Just kind of set those for yourself and really, have those laid out so you can easily identify what goals you need to set. And that's going to go into step two, or to point number two, which is setting goals, I believe. You want to set goals accordingly to the plans that you've made, okay? So when it comes to plans and goals, they're kind of related a lot. When it comes to goals, what I like to follow, a certain formula that I follow from Project Life Mastery, some of you may know him already, Stephen James, but he says that you map out your goals as, or you write your goals out as, I will easily achieve, or, fill in the blank, by December 31st, 2019, right? That's an example for a yearly goal. So for example, let's say one of my goals is I will easily make, $25,000 a month by December 31st, 2019, okay? That's a simple goal. And that's kind of how I would write it out. And that's how I'm gonna print out my goals and put them up on my wall, okay? So that's just an example of a goal that I would, that's kind of the structure that I would write it in, because it's very specific. And then what I can do then is make a plan. You kind of want to use planning and goals like in relation to each other. Once you've identified that goal after you've done your planning, then you can go back and kind of plan, okay, how can I hit this goal? How am I going to do this? What can I do monthly? What can I do weekly? And what can I do daily? Now, obviously certain goals are going to be different, but you really want to map out and be clear on what that daily action is, because the daily things that you do are the things that you're going to be able to do 365 days in 2019 to help you reach your end goal, which is to make $25,000 a month, or whatever the goal is, okay? That, I just use that as an example. So just be thinking about those things and really try and write down as many goals as you can, okay? And goals just aren't about business. They're about, health and relationships. They're about your fitness. They're about, your spirituality, your mindset, right? There's just so many different aspects that you can kind of set goals for. And I highly encourage you to make sure you do that, because for me, this year, one thing that I've neglected to do is really set goals, or I guess strive for other goals outside of business. I've really taken kind of a really heavy focus on business, and this year I really want to get other aspects of my life in order too, because I know it's going to help me perform and be more successful in my business, okay? So just remember that. So that's kind of the second point that I wanted to lay out. And really what you want to do is make sure that when you're setting these goals, that they're specific, there's something that you truly desire after, and that there's something that really motivates you, right? Now, if you want to achieve a certain outcome, you need to make sure you're specific about that certain outcome, right? Now, you can't just say, I want to start an online business. Like, what do you want to do? What type of online business do you want to start? What is it that you want to actually do? An example might be, I want to start a social media marketing agency and get, five clients that are generating me $5,000 a month, right? By, say July of this year, of 2019, right? That's a really specific goal where you can say, okay, what do I need to do in order to hit that goal, right? So monthly actions. I need to get one new client a month to hit, five clients by, July. Or I guess that's 7 months in. So maybe it's by May or June, right? You need one client a month going from January on to May. and that will get you to 5,000 a month, right? So then you can map out, okay, what do I need to do weekly? Well, I need to prospect to this many people. I need to outreach to this many businesses, or I need to do, you know, this many a day. So when you can break it down like that, it helps you know, okay, this is my end goal. Now I'm creating my left and right turns, my, you know, straight line, you know, turn on this way, turn this way. And the end of the goal where you've set it, you're gonna be able to reach it because you've planned, okay, I plan my monthly, I plan my weekly, I plan my daily. So now you know exactly what you need to do right now to get to that destination in 5 months, okay? So I hope that makes sense. So mapping out, having a roadmap for to your destination is so crucial for hitting goals, all right? So I hope that makes sense. Now, I'll probably do another video here diving into more specifics of the planning and goal setting aspect, because I think it's super, super important. There's a lot to cover, but I hope you've gotten the general idea of what you really need to do to, you know, plan and set those goals, okay? Make sure you take time to go and actually think. Like, I like to be out in nature, I mentioned in my last video, and think. Find a place where you like to think, where you can brainstorm, and dedicate hours in your day, or even just an hour a day, to sit down before the new year and just think about what you want in life, okay? I promise it'll be very, very helpful. So, the third thing, piece of advice I'd like to share is, you'll need to make sacrifices, okay? What I see here, yeah, be ready to make sacrifices. So one of the things that I've understood these last 2 years I've been fully involved in entrepreneurship is that if you want to achieve goals that other people haven't achieved, you know, because most people are working a 9-to-5 job, most people don't have the courage or the ability to take a risk or to have the time they want to dedicate to prioritize really hitting goals in their lives, right? Like whether it's, you know, getting really fit, or whether it's, you know, starting a business that's really successful and quitting your job, or whether it's, you know, developing better relationships or finding, you know, your significant other, your soulmate, right? Like you have to really sacrifice things in your life in order to actually achieve that. So remember that going in 2019, think about the things that you can sacrifice, like TV, video games, even too much socializing and making sure you're socializing with the right people, you know, reading too many books or fiction books, you know, whatever the case may be. Think about those things that aren't actually helping contribute to your end destination or your bigger vision, because those are the things that you need to say, okay, look, I really love doing these things, but I need to drop them out of my life in order for me to hit my goals, okay? Now, you don't have to sacrifice everything, but I'm saying you need to make the sacrifices that most people aren't willing to make, okay? That's what I've learned. In order for me to, you know, have worked on for myself for these past 2 years, I've had to make sacrifices with friends. I've had to make sacrifices watching less TV. I've had to make sacrifices playing less video games. And that's so important and such a huge factor in success, is you gotta think to yourself, what are you willing to give up for the thing that you want, okay? So think about the sacrifices, make a decision and make a commitment before 2019 in your head first, that you will not, you know, get involved with those certain activities, you know, a certain thing that you want to sacrifice. Like you really have to make that commitment and decision in your mind in order for it to happen in, you know, real life, okay? If you haven't decided in your mind, you're only 50-50, you're still gonna end up doing those things in 2019. So make a decision now, say, I am going to do this, I'm not going to do this in 2019. I'm gonna spend this time working on building my agency, right? So that's just an example. So be ready to make sacrifices, because that's so important to really achieve the success that you want. Sun's coming through now, it's going in my face. That's okay. Got one more point here. And the last point that I wanted to share is don't give up, okay? Now it may sound so generic, but let me explain, okay? Now, these last 2 years for me, I've had so many ups and downs, you know. I've gone from making, you know, $0 a month, you know, the last 2 years, 2.5 years, or how long has it been? It's nearly been 2 years. I've gone from making $0 to $2,000 a month, up to $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 a month. I've gone down to, you know, $3,000 or $4,000. Like, I've gone up and down quite a bit this year, okay? And it's been a really good experience, but I've really had a lot of ups and downs. I've had some really good moments, I've had some, you know, not so good moments. And for me, I think that in reality, like, I really appreciate my ability to persevere through the trials and challenges that I've had this year. Like, I can't tell you guys how many times that I've thought that I wanted to give up. I can't tell you how many times I'm like, is this entrepreneurship thing for me? Is it really gonna work for me? Like, am I really gonna have the level of success that I want? Now, you could, you know, I think that oftentimes I forget that I consider myself successful, and obviously successful is all subjective, right, to the actual individual. But for me, you know, I've always wanted to be making, you know, 10,000 plus a month, right? Like, that's kind of what I wanna be able to do. And I know that 2019, it's going to happen. And I think that for me, I need to remember that measuring success isn't just about money. It's about all the other aspects too. Like, the fulfillment that I get out of making content for you guys is truly the most powerful thing for me that really motivates me and makes me happy. And I think that, you know, that's kind of helped me to not give up, you know? And I think it's such an important thing to have is snow coming down off the trees, is to have grit. I'm reading a book right now that talks about grit and how, you know, no matter what challenges and trials that you face, you just have to persevere and you have to get through it, all right? No matter how hard it is, no matter how much you don't want to do it, no matter how much you want to give up, you have to be 100% fully committed to making your dreams come true, to making your goals happen and you getting to your destination and reaching your greater vision, okay? So make the decision that no matter what happens in 2019, whether, you know, I hate to say it, family member dies, you know, you go into a lot of debt, you know, whatever the struggle is, you know, you have emotional issues or you have relationship issues, like whatever the case may be, decide today that no matter what happens, you'll still persevere and never give up on your goals and dreams that you're going into achieving in 2019 so that you can really make it the best year that you've ever had, okay? So hopefully those 4 points have been helpful. I know I've kind of been a bit scatterbrained, but I just wanted to get on camera here and just share that because for me, those 4 things are something that I've been thinking about a lot lately, and I've really noticed they've contributed to me getting where I am right now. And I want to help you guys to really have 2019 be one of your best years ever. And I want 2019 to be my best year ever, where I'm planning out everything, I'm setting goals for everything, I know what I'm doing each month, and I'm gonna make it happen by taking massive action and executing all the things that I have planned and the things that I'm gonna do. And I'm not gonna give up in 2019. I know that I have to make more sacrifices, and I'm gonna continue to push and push and push until I can achieve my goals and my aspirations. So hopefully this has been inspirational for you guys, helpful. We're leaving Jackson right now. My wife's in the car, it's pretty cold out here. And we're gonna be heading back. I'm really excited to get back into a proper work schedule. Things have been a bit off here while I've been in Jackson, but if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you subscribe to this channel for more content. 2019 is gonna be a huge year for this YouTube channel. And if you enjoy this video, if it's helpful or valuable for you, leave a like on this video. And if you have any thoughts or comments or questions, leave them below in the comment section below and I'll get back to you. But thanks so much, guys. I hope you had a great Christmas and a happy new year. I'll probably be talking to you very soon, but thanks so much, guys, and have a great day.